Hey guys. So I've gotten some requests to do a video on what the inside of the 4100ES looks like. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to show you guys what is really going on behind this, behind the front, behind the display, the audio bay. So yeah, let's get started. All right, so I've taken the dress panel off. As you can see, it's right here. So we'll go ahead and start with the top bay. Pop this down. And when I bring this down, you can see the back of the operator's interface. So this board is where all the buttons sit, the LCD screen, which is right here. Right here is the piezo. Now you can see we have two ribbon cables here coming from the CPU card. This ribbon cable right here is the communication to the operator's interface. So for when you press the buttons and read what the LCD says, that ribbon cable does all that. This ribbon cable right here is for when techs dump the program into the CPU card. And here is the CPU card itself. It looks a bit different than the Simplex 4100U CPU card, if you guys are familiar with what that looks like. So back here, the CPU card plugs into what's called a 4100 CPU motherboard. And it says it right there. And the part number is 566227. So you can also put in another card. I believe you can plug a network card in there so you can network all the panels together, depending on how many panels you have. So if we move over to the right, you can see we have the system power supplier, also known as the SPS. Right here is the SLC, or also known as the IDNet loop. So Simplex uses IDNet and MapNet, but this is using IDNet. Now, as you can see, we have jumpers from Class A to Class B. This panel is Class A by default. You'll also notice how we also had to do that on the Simplex 4010. We had to put jumpers from Class A to Class B so it would dummy out that trouble. Over here, we have three notification appliance circuits. Only one is being used, and that is going to the strobes for the speaker strobes, and the other two have been resistored off. Now, you can also program the NACs to do different things. So right now, we have this set as SQ alert. This is set to S visual, which means the strobes will stop when you hit alarm silence. And we have this one set to R visual, which means the strobes will stop once the system resets. So down here, these terminals, this 24 volt auxiliary power, we have right here this module behind this black plate, and the 24 volt auxiliary power is feeding power to this module. So, and like I said, I have this module here in case I want to add any conventional devices in the future. And this auxiliary relay right here that we have, this is tripping the security system. So this goes to one of the zones on the Vista, and it needs a resistor. However, the Vista is not programmed to look for a resistor, but I need to do that. So when the 4100ES goes into fire alarm, the relay, the contacts close, and that puts this Vista into fire alarm. So that's the first bay. Not a lot going on, but now we'll put that back up and we'll move on to the second bay. All right, so at the second bay, we got some things going on that are a little bit different. So as you can see right here, we have our microphone. We have our buttons for, this is the command center. So audio control. And we have our local speaker, all speakers talk, ready to, so when you press all speakers talk and you press the microphone and ready to talk, that'll let you know you're good to talk through the microphone. Selective evac and all speakers evac. So if I press this, it does a manual evacuation without the strobes. So let's go ahead and we'll flip this down. And here's what we got going on inside here. So here's our local speaker. This is the wire that goes to this card right here. This is the analog audio control card. So the microphone, you're able to, so this is what plays the message for the Simplex, like the slow loop and the voice evacuation. So yeah. Over here, or I'm sorry, right here, this card right here, this is called the power distribution interface, or also known as the PDI board. This allows you to plug cards in or power supplies, and that's how they get their power, and that's how they're also able to communicate with the CPU card. So right here, this is called a Flex Amp 50, this card right here in the middle. This is where your speakers tie into. So as you can see, I have my two wires for my speaker, and the other two NACs are resistored off. And yes, you can also have shielded cable on this as well. Move over to the right. This is the XPS, also known as the expansion power supply. So this is just a multiplier of the regular horn strobe NACs that the SPS has. You cannot wire speakers to the regular NACs, and you cannot have strobes on the speaker circuits. This is specifically designed for speakers, and this is specifically designed for horn strobes. And I also have this set up the same way. SQ alert, S visual, R visual. So I'm able to do different things with the notification appliance circuits, which I like. So you also notice we have a red and black wire here. This is not the primary source of electricity. The primary source is 120 volts. These are battery cables that plug in to the XPS and also on the SPS. Back here, you'll see we also have them right here as well. And there is our 120 volt primary power that powers the SPS during normal operation. Right, and the XPS also has the same thing. So we'll go ahead and close this up. We'll take a look under here. There's our 120 volts powering the XPS. And if we come right here, you'll notice that we have this device right here. This is called a power distribution module, also known as PDM for short. We have our 120 volt primary power coming in, and our ground wire grounds right to the can. Right here, we have these two plugs, which plug into the power distribution module. And this is what gives power to the first bay and the second bay. Or I'm sorry, the SPS and the XPS. So, and right here, these are where our batteries plug into. Now, you'll notice we have our 120 volts and our battery power. So during normal operation, power comes in and it goes through these wires, the hot and the neutral. When AC power is lost, the batteries then take over and the electricity still travels through the power distribution module, but through the battery cables to supply secondary power for a minimum of 24 hours. So that was just a quick overview on what's going on inside of the 4100ES. I know I still have to get stickers that make it a 4100ES, but it is an ES. If you guys have any questions whatsoever, please feel free to reach out. I'm always happy to help. I love it when people want to learn. I love sharing my knowledge with people. If you guys want to see more videos like this, comment below. Thanks for watching.